my husband doesn't consider himself my caretaker, which until he has to like wipe my bum, I don't think I want him to be my caretaker. But we are sort of we feel like we're sort of even in this journey. And but we sort of, at that point, we sort of started arguing a lot more, and we didn't know why. And you know, anxiety, you know, yes, hi, Yogi. And just getting angry at the kids, or not me, but like, just, I was sort of like, it's okay, don't worry about it. And Jill was like, frustrated. And so we called a trauma counselor for Joel and I, and we said, okay, this, something has to happen, or we're just gonna kill each other. Because we couldn't figure out why. Like, it wasn't, I had done something, he had done something. It was just like, any tiny little thing bothered me, and any tiny little thing bothered him. And so, saw a trauma counselor, and that first day, we were sort of venting about each other. And she goes, when was the last time you, like, did something together? And we're like, well, we don't have time for that. She goes, well, you need to make time. You just need to go on a date. Just go for coffee. Plan it. Put it in the calendar. And we did. We saw her a couple more times, but almost after that first time, we went on a date. Just, we went for coffee, I think. We went to Starbucks and got a latte and sat and talked and about nothing. And it was awesome. And that immediately we're like, oh, this is what we needed to do. Like, we needed to spend an hour just on the two of us. And then it became more time and then more time. And now we're good. We're like in a really great place in our relationship. And thankfully, when I was first diagnosed, we were in a really good place too.